So here we have a heat sink above a board. There are cutouts underneath the heat sink that provide a clearance to the components on the board. If you look at the cross section, you can see that the slots between the fins are adjusted to make sure there is consistent material thickness across the uneven base. Let's go through the workflow that was used to produce this heatsink. I'm starting with this board with some components modeled in. I've also modeled a simple cuboid that represents the heatsink. This cuboid has been modeled right on the top face of the board. I've created a copy of the board. The first step is to create a consistent gap between the board components, and the heatsink. Let's hide the original board and the heatsink. Go to Modify, Offset Face. Select all faces. Set an offset distance of 2. We will use this as a dummy body to cut into the heatsink block. Bring back the heatsink. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the heatsink block as the target body. Select the dummy board with the offset as the tool body. Set operation to cut. Since we do not need the dummy board after this operation, we do not need to check on the keep tools option. Let's bring back the original board. If we take a look at the cross section, we can see that there is a consistent gap between the board and the heatsink. This applies to the board components as well. Let's hide the board for now. The challenge comes when we need to cut the slots to form the heat fins. During cutting, not only do we need to avoid these cavities, we also need a consistent wall thickness across the base of the heatsink. We need to create a reference surface body for doing the extruded cut. Activate the surface workspace. Go to Create, Offset. Let's look normal to the base face and select all the faces. Drag select from right to left, keeping the cursor within the outlines of the base at all times. In this case, I have wrongly selected the top face also. Let's unselect that. Set an offset distance of 2. We need to reverse the offset by entering a negative value. So we have created a limit for which the extruder cut should be performed up to. I have prepared a sketch for the first slot. Activate a solid workspace. Begin the extrude command. Select the profile. For extent, select tool object. Select the surface body as the object. You can see that the cut is performed only up to the surface body. The cavities on the base of the heat sink do not form a linear pattern. Does this mean that we need to perform each cut individually to create the fins? Fortunately, the answer is no. The pattern command is intelligent enough to adjust a cut as it moves across the base. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. Set the object type as Features. Select the extruded cut as a feature. For axis, click on the select box and select the x-axis. Set distribution type to spacing. Adjust the quantity and spacing. In order for each patterned cut to conform to the surface body as a pattern moves across, we need to set compute type to adjust. You can see that each subsequent patterned cut honors the up to object rule set in the first cut. Hope you have found this useful. I will see you in the next one.